Okay, everyone, it's time for another rapid randomizer review. Let's see what we've got. Mission to the Unknown. If you want to be surprised by Doctor Who, try a rapid randomizer review.
Our whole galaxy is to be invaded and destroyed.
So those of you more familiar with the new series will know about Dr. Light episodes. These are episodes which are double-banked with other episodes in the season, which don't feature the Doctor quite so much. Now, the classic series didn't do this so much, but they did do a single story made up of one 25-minute episode that didn't feature the Doctor at all. He still gets his credit at the end because that was the contract. Mission to the Unknown is a 25-minute prologue to the upcoming 12-part epic The Daleks Master Plan. And it arose because an earlier 4-part story was cut down to 3 parts, but the production team still had to deliver that extra episode. But the series stars, including William Hartnell, had already made all the episodes that their contract stated. So it was either issue another contract for the stars or write a story without the stars in it. And the production team knew they had this 12-part epic coming up, so they decided to write a story setting the scene for that. So the main character is instead Space Security Service Agent Mark Corey, and he is on a mission to discover a secret plan by the Daleks, and the Daleks are intending to invade the solar system. Now, there's some debate as to whether this means just our solar system, or it's kind of used to describe Earth's galaxy, but whatever, the Daleks are going to invade. And they've set up this alliance of aliens from other galaxies and other star systems in order to invade Earth. What's really notable about the story is Corey is kind of a space James Bond. At this point, creator of the Daleks, Terry Nation, was looking at developing a Dalek series on their own up against a human defense force, if you like, or this special space security force. It has lots of S's in it. Now, that idea never got off the ground, and this is sort of a glimpse at what might have been, except for the fact that, spoiler alert, all the humans die within it. I'm not sure why the decision was made not to, say, have Mark Corey stay on for the full story that comes later. He's replaced by two other similar characters who play kind of the same role in the plot. What this means this story does is it shows the Daleks at their most ruthless. They just kill all the humans within this story. And one of them dies really quite horrifically, kind of turning into a plant monster. It's really quite effective. It's also very pulpy, sort of Flash Gordon-style sci-fi. And it sets up the story to come. I give this 7 out of 10. Look, it doesn't exist. The vision of this story doesn't exist. The audio does, so you can listen to it on audio. There are reconstructions of it. There's even an unofficial animation, which you may be able to find on certain video sharing sites. It was commissioned by Ian Levine. The BBC passed on buying it, which is a real pity. It's very good quality animation. I'm not going to link to it because Ian has requested that people don't, but I can't stop you searching for Mission to the Unknown animation. That's on you. But certainly, 7 out of 10, it's worth watching or listening, somehow experiencing, before jumping into the Daleks Master Plan. And just as an odd little quirk of Doctor Who history, a story without the Doctor at all. And everyone dies. I'm recording a little extra note here because that Rapid Randomizer review was recorded back in December. The first 6 Rapid Randomizer reviews I did just all in one day, so there's one more to come from that batch next week. And just when I decided to relaunch my channel, I knew I had Last Christmas coming up next, but I didn't know what I had coming up after that. U-Clan then announced that they were releasing their Mission to the Unknown remake, which they had shot several months earlier. And it just so happens that this one, Mission to the Unknown, comes out the week that U-Clan have released their version. And so I could hardly finish that review without saying something about the U-Clan remake, which was announced, produced, and now released in the intervening time from when I shot that Rapid Randomizer review to now.
So obviously the story is no different. The script has been very faithfully reproduced. So I'm going to talk more about the production values. I'm not going to say too much though, because I just encourage you to go watch it. I don't want to spoil what they've done by describing it in great detail to you. But it looks like a 1960s episode of Doctor Who. The design, the camera movements, even the acting styles that these young actors have adopted. Marco Simeoni, who plays the new version of Mark Corey, sounds like Edward D'Souza. It's quite amazing, because of course for years, all we've had of this story has been the soundtrack. As I mentioned, there's some unofficial reconstructions and an unofficial animation out there, but there's so little pictorial evidence of this show. And as far as I know, no photos of Edward D'Souza as Mark Corey. Lots of photos of Edward D'Souza from the period, which were used to make the reconstruction, but none of him or Barry Jackson or Jeremy Young, who are the three human characters. The sets are amazingly faithful reproductions. You've got Nick Briggs doing the Dalek voices and giving it sort of real Peter Hawkins and David Graham energy, as is appropriate for the period. And it's just excellent. So for this one, I'm actually giving another score. And this isn't so much for the script, but it's for the faithfulness to the production look and feel and aesthetic of the period. And I just have to give the U-Clan remake 10 out of 10 full marks. Just really well done. And if you haven't watched it, stop watching this and go watch that. And you can stop watching this anyway, because this is the end. And I'll be reviewing the Ghost Monument tomorrow. See you then.